In the previous video, I demonstrated deploying an application, that is the frontend application, on the Kubernetes engine by Google. We already have a cluster created and then the workloads defined along with the service which exposes this application using a load balancer to the outside world. Now, I'm going to start showing you what happens in the background, what's behind the scene, and what are the primitives that Kubernetes creates and what does each of that mean, starting with deployments. So when we created the workload, it actually created in a deployment for it. And if you look at the deployment configuration, it shows you how many number of pods you have running for it. Earlier, when I created it, it showed me 3 pods running right here. Now it has scaled down to just 1. And this is dynamic scaling. And when you create it with Google Compute Engine and deploy it using this console right here, it by default creates something called as autoscaler. It's also called as horizontal pod autoscaler in Kubernetes terminology. The main purpose of that is to maintain the number of replicas and dynamically scale based on the threshold. The target here we have defined, the threshold is the metric is CPU utilization. And since there is no CPU utilization on this cluster right now, it has scaled down from 3 to 1 instances of that application. Now, whether it scales up, scales down, it does the deployment and maintains the number of replicas through something called as a concept of deployments. And the purpose of deployments is basically you want to run an application. With Kubernetes, you run it in the form of containers. And those are run through pods. We're going to talk about pods shortly. But basically, if you want to deploy an application with Kubernetes, you create a deployment. And deployment in turn creates a replication controller. It has 2 purposes. One is to maintain the number of replicas. Right now it is 1, but earlier it had 3 instances of my deployment. In fact, I can scale that manually as well and change the number of instances from this YAML configuration as well, right? So, that is something I'm going to show you in another video, the scaling part of this deployment. So, 2 purposes mainly, to maintain the number of replicas, and this is useful for fault tolerance and high availability as well, because whenever any of these instances goes down, it is automatically going to create another one, maybe on another node and so on. So this is called as replication. So deployment maintains number of replicas and replication through something called as replica set. Replica set is a type of replication controller. The second purpose of deployment is provide you with an ability to upgrade from version 1 to version 2 or from one version to another version. And you can create a strategy. You can deploy that without a downtime. You can do that with downtime. It's up to you. So it gives you the strategy to define the upgrade policy from one version to another one. So deployment does mainly 2 things. One is replication controller, controlling the replicas, and second is it offers you with the strategy. And then along with horizontal pod autoscaler, it also gives you an ability to scale out and scale in based on the metrics which include the CPU utilization. And that's the reason why if I want to demonstrate deployment in Kubernetes, this is how it looks like. So you create a deployment configuration which provides strategy and replica sets. Replica set is responsible for maintaining the replicas. Replicas of what? You deploy it using a pod, so it maintains the pod specification. If you write a deployment configuration, it is going to look like this. It contains the pod specification, replica set configuration, and then the strategy. This is an example of a YAML spec for the deployment. Now, talking about replication, it maintains that using a replication controller or a replica set. And the way it works is, let's say if you do not have the replication controllers, this is what would happen. Let's say you have deployed 3 tiers or 3 services, 3 applications on Kubernetes. They're running on 3 different nodes. Now, if you do not have replication controller, if one of the application, let's say just one instance of this application running here, goes down, or this node for example, the underlying node has a problem, and if that goes down, you're gonna lose your instances. And if you lose that instance, your availability is affected here. Your application is down. That could be a problem. So in order to maintain that availability and provide you with a fault tolerance or auto healing, replication controllers constantly monitor for your instances. You define the number of instances. Let's say you define minimum as one. It is going to keep on monitoring. If there is a underlying failure or a pod goes down, or the container goes down, or the instance goes down, it will automatically recreate it, reschedule it, possibly on other nodes. And that happens in an automated way. So it is constantly monitoring for the pods. And the way it monitors it is using labels. So you, when you deploy your application, you label those. And I'm going to show you an example of that. This is an application. And when you deployed that application, it created these labels. So the replication controller is monitoring for anything which has a label which says app is frontend. And that's what you would see here as well. If you go and look at the pod, this is a pod configuration, pod spec. There's one pod running. You see the monitoring graph for that pod as well. And the label has been assigned as app frontend. And there is a replica set or replication controller which is monitoring for these pods. And the role of that replication replica set, typically with deployment, is to maintain the number of replicas as per the specification provided by the deployment or by the auto scaler. And it keeps on managing that, maintaining that by using something called a selector. So a replication controller has a selector, and through that selector, it is going to monitor for the available set of pods. And this is how it is going to differentiate. So this replica set is for an application called as carts. So anything which matches that, only the carts applications or instances would be monitored by this replication controller. So it has to match. So labels have to match the selectors. And earlier, Kubernetes started with replication controllers, but now it is replica set. To briefly tell you the difference between the two, this is sort of an advanced version of it, and it allows you to not only do A and B. So this is where it selects based on both A and B. It has to match both of these. Versus replica set can allow you to do set based selector, where you can say A and B, and either V or V2 or V3. So it allows you to do both anding and oring, which gives you a better finer grain control over selection criteria. And then you can define the strategy, which can be by default is rolling update. Rolling update maintains the uptime of the application, so that when you're upgrading from version 1 to version 2, it does it in batches. So it will start a couple of new instances, bring down the previous ones, and then launch the new ones in a rolling manner, so that at any given point of time, even during the deployment, you have at least few instances available, either with this version or this version. You can also use another replication strategy called as recreate, whereas you bring down all the instances in a typical release that you've been cutting, and then cut over to the next version. So that's what deployments do. Deployments give you a way to run your application, run your workloads in the form of containers, and it maintains uptime, high availability, and it gives you a way to define your release strategy or deployment strategy.